Now this is part 2 of lecture number 14, because in my previous video I don't know how audio got switched off, so that video is without audio, so I am repeating again that lecture. Now here I will take this problem, automatic tank filling plant with PLC but without using SR flip flop. So here I am using simple relay logic and without SR solution of this problem, without SR block is not in any book. So please be attentive and see how I am solving this problem. So first I will draw this latch circuit to keep this pump and motor continuously running. So this is that latch circuit. Let us say this is a start switch 1 and 001, and this is a stop switch 1 and 002. This is CR1 and this is CR1. So once I press this, don't forget to give a rung number. If I press this, supply is through and this is already through, so this will get activated and as a result this will go high. So now there is an alternate path of power. This way this travels. If I leave this, this will not go low, so this is latched and this remains on. Now here again I will use one more switch, which is CR1. Now here this is that motor for pump. Now here some switches should be connected. Now just pay attention here. Water will start only when water has gone down below N2 sensor. Now if water reaches to this level, in that position here switch is hanging, here sensor or float switch is hanging, and if that switch is hanging, that is in NC position, connected position, and here N2 is also in hanging position, so switch is also connected. So if I draw here two switches connected in this way, this is N1 and this is N2, and if I give this to motor, now if I latch this, start this, this will go high, this will go high, motor will start, water pump will start. Now water is delivered to overhead tank. The moment water is delivered, here water level will start rising. The moment water level start rising here, N2 switch which was floating or hanging will go this way and this will float like this. So immediately if water level rises, N2 switch or sensor switch will change its position from NC to NO. Now if this happens, here this will go from NC to NO, this will break and motor will stop. So this should not happen, or something should be done so that even if here N2 has gone upside down from NC to NO, motor should not stop. So here I will add one trick, that is, now when water was here, pump will start. Now right now pump is running and water is rising in this. So in this condition or at that position, now motor is high or motor is running. So I can bypass N2 in this way with one switch. I will number this as a M. Now if in this condition, here water is here, motor is running and pump water is being pumped to this overhead tank. So this already we have latched, so this is connected and these both are connected, and motor runs, water rises. The moment water rises, N2 will go from hanging position to floating position. This will open up, but as this is high or running, as a result this gets connected. So even though this goes up and this goes from NC to NO, this has an alternative path, so motor will not stop. So water will continue pumping, being pumped here, and water rises, and the moment water reaches to N1, now this water, rising water, will lift this N1 and N1 sensor will go from NC to NO. Here from NC to NO, if this happens, this will go from NC to NO, here circuit breaks, motor will stop. As motor stops, this will also go low, or this will come in this position. So at when water touches N1, motor will stop. So further rising of water in this will stop, motor will stop. Now here water is being used continuously, so water will start going down. Now if water goes down, N1 will get connected, but as this is in NO position and this is low because motor has stopped. So even though this is connected, but motor will not restart. Motor will restart only when water reaches below N2. If water goes below N2, this gets connected and this is through. So motor starts running, and the moment motor starts running, because of this, this will get connected this way, or this is latched, so water will rise. And again, if this happens, water rises and N2 will go from NC to NO. This will go from NC to NO. Nothing will happen because we have an alternative path. So motor keeps running continuously till water reaches to N1. Now in between, if water here touches the footwall switch and goes below N4, so if water is being pumped here, water is rising here, but in between, if this water reaches to footwall level and goes below N4, the right now N4 is in this position. This is floating upside down, and in that floating upside down we have a NC position, right? So here I will draw one more switch. I will number this as a N4, and which is in NC condition. Now if water is being pumped here, and in between if water goes down, in that case here float switch N4 will come from floating position to hanging position. If this happens, this will go from NC to NO. This will open up. Now if this opens again, this will stop. So if water is being pumped and water goes below N4 or footwall, again pump will stop. So this solution is satisfying all three conditions, and this is the solution for this.